for the audience member that cannot get up yet physically, or those recommendations would be contrary to doctor's orders, do not get up, okay? You certainly do not want to create a worsened condition than you already have.
That's right.
And we are not recommending that anyone cross the line of clinical instability or anything else. But there's a point year after year after year where you have to take a risk. And you have to expand the boundaries that are beyond the bed, and then the bedroom, and then the bathroom, and then the living room. You have to expand boundaries to see what you can do. And so getting out of bed, as I mentioned earlier, just taking that first step and standing up, you're already saying, I am not going to take the path of least resistance. I'm willing to venture in a new way of thinking and in a new way of moving with my life. That's how the first steps started for me.
Yeah.
So that was something that was very crucial. And a lesson that I learned actually came from a scripture in Corinthians. And it was this. It says this, but we already basically have this treasure, which is light, if you have Christ in you. And it's an invitation for anyone. Everyone can have Christ in them. In earthen vessels or hearts, so that the surpassing greatness of the power will be of God and not from ourselves.
That's good.
So I realized I didn't have any power to keep trying to fight against pain and to climb over it and to leave it permanently off my back. The power that was being demonstrated was the idea of surrendering to God fully.
Yep.
And to allow him to fill in the gaps and to learn how to trust him in my walk of faith. The scripture also says this, and I understand this. We are afflicted in every way. I've heard this message described and explained several times where, okay, you're not crushed, but you're perplexed, and you're not despairing, but you're persecuted. But the point is this. We are going to become afflicted in every way. And that was something I hadn't really heard before until I experienced pain.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, but we're not crushed. We are perplexed, but not despairing, persecuted, but not forsaken, struck down, but not destroyed. Always caring about in the body the dying of Jesus so that the life of Jesus may also be manifested in our body.
Yes.
And I was saying this, I want the life of Jesus manifested in me. If I'm going to get out of bed and I can only stand, I need his power.
Amen.
To move my next steps.
I believe that. The battle is for life. The battle is about life. And when the enemy proclaims death, the battle cry is for life.
Yes.
Even in pain.
Even in pain. And many of us will still have that thorn in the flesh and will still have pain even to the end of this mortal life that we have right here on this planet.
That's right.